question, we are going to see how to solve this triple summation question. It may look very complicated, but if we make basic modifications, this will become so much easier. The first set of changes that we'll be doing in the summation is going to be A will be changed to B and B will be changed to C, then C will be changed to A, which is called as the cyclic changes that we are going to make here. So let's see what are we going to get, okay? So S is going to be equal to triple summation that we have here. So this is AB into 3A plus C upon, I'm writing this denominator as K for simplicity. So now one thing that you can see, even if you modify A to B, B to C and then C to A, the denominator remains same. Not only modifying all the three at the time, even if you modify any two, still the denominator will remain same. For example, let's interchange A and B. Then this A plus B will become B plus A. This B plus C will become A plus C. And this C plus A will become C plus B. So this part is going to remain exactly same. And also this 4 ways to A plus B plus C will also be same, right? So you interchange all the three in a cyclic manner, or you interchange any two, still the denominator part is going to remain same. Only the numerator is changing. So this is actually the clue that we have in this summation, which we will be taking as advantage to proceed with the question, right? So first, this is the S that we have here. The first modification that we are going to apply on this one is going to be the cyclic change, where we are going to modify all the three, right? So A will go to B and this B will go to C and this 3A will become 3B and the C will become A and the denominator will remain same. So that will be equal to K only. And we are going to apply the cyclic change one more time here. So let's see, what are we going to get here? Triple summation, and this B into C will now automatically become C into A, and this 3B plus A will become 3C plus B upon K, right? So that is what we got here after applying the cyclic changes. Now we are going to make another modification on these summations. Like each of these terms that we got, we are going to apply one more modification to get our required answer. So let's see that one. As I told, even if you modify, if you interchange any two, still we are going to get the same denominator. So that is exactly what I'm going to do here. In this first one, I'm going to interchange B and C. From where we are getting the idea here? Here we got 3A plus C, right? Here we are having the term 3A plus C. Now I'm trying to get the term 3A plus B. So that is what is actually telling you, we have to interchange this B and C here. So then what are we going to get? This S will again be same only. So that S is going to be summation. This will become AC, as we are interchanging C with B and B with C. So this B will become C and 3A will remain like that only. And C will become now B and the denominator still remains same. So apply the similar type of changes in the remaining two summations also. Here we are going to interchange A and C because we got 3B plus A. Now we are trying to get 3B plus C. So A will be changed with C. So S will become triple summation. And here this B into C will become now B into A. And in the bracket, we are going to get 3B plus C upon the same denominator K. And similarly, here we are going to interchange A with B and B with A. So your S will become triple summation. This will be CB multiplied with 3C plus A upon K. So now here, one thing that you can observe here. So we got total six different ways of writing the same S. Now we'll be adding all these six to get our required answer. So let's proceed and add these six different ways of writing S to get our answer. So here, this 6S is going to become triple summation, and all of them have the same denominator K. Only the numerator is changing, right? So we have the numerator as AB into 3A plus C. Then we have another term that is AC into 3A plus B. Then we have third term, which is going to be BC into 3B plus A, and so on. So total, we have six terms in the numerator, and all of them have the same denominator K, right? So now 6S is going to come as triple summation. Now, one thing that you can directly see in the numerator, what terms that we have here. So when you multiply this, you'll be getting 3a square b. This multiplication is going to give you 3a square b, and this multiplication is going to give you 3a square c, and this multiplication is giving 3b square c. And there are remaining three other multiplications which will give you all possible multiplications like 3a square b, 3a square c, 3b square c, and so on. So, right? So let's write all those. That will be 3a square b plus this is 3a square c. Then we'll be getting 3b square c and 3b square a. Then we'll be getting 3c square a and 3c square b, right? That you can very easily check by going to the previous screen here. So we will be getting different six different types of multiplications here, which we have written here. So now every term here is going to give you one ABC. Every term here is going to give you one ABC, and we have total six such terms. So this will become six times of ABC upon the denominator. So what was the denominator we have here? That is 4 raised to a plus b plus c multiplied with a plus b into b plus c into c plus a, right? So now, another thing that is going to happen here. So if we go and multiply this a plus b into b plus c into c plus a, what will happen? That very easily you can expand this. We will be getting this one as a square b plus a square c and b square a plus b square c plus c square a plus c square b plus two times of abc. That very easily you can check by doing that multiplication here. We will be getting these terms. Now, one thing that you can directly see here, when we cancel out this one with this, we are going to left with 3 in the numerator, right? Because the numerator is 3 times whatever we got here. So ultimately, what we got here, 6s is going to be triple summation. The numerator will be 3. Upon in the denominator, we have only 4 times of 4 raised to a plus b plus c. So now you can cancel out this 3 with this 6 here because this is a constant. So you can take this to the left side and you can cancel out. So that will ultimately will give you 2s is going to be equal to triple summation and 1 upon this 4 raised to a plus b plus c can be taken as simply 4 raised to a into 4 raised to b into 4 raised to c, right? So now we are going to make another modification here to get our final answer. So let's see that. So far we got 2s is equal to summation on a, summation on b, and summation on c. And here we got 1 upon 4 raised to a and 1 upon 4 raised to b, 1 upon 4 raised to c. Now, one interesting thing that you can see here, when I talk about this summation, which has on c, this 1 upon 4 raised to and 1 upon 4 raised to b will behave like constants. So they can be taken outside this summation. Now, using exactly the same logic, here we got 1 upon 4 raised to a multiplied with 1 upon 4 raised to b. Again, this 1 upon 4 raised to a will become constant with respect to this summation. So I can further take this one outside the summation. So ultimately, we got here 2s is equal to summation a 1 upon 4 raised to a multiplied with summation on b 1 upon 4 raised to b multiplied with summation 1 upon 4 raised to c, right? So now here, as we know, a is changing from 1 to infinite, right? So here the summation is a is from 1 to infinite 1 upon 4 raised to a multiplied with summation b is from 1 to infinite 1 upon 4 raised to b multiplied with summation c is 1 to infinite 1 upon 4 raised to c, right? So now we can just simply expand this summation here to form a series, and let's see what are we going to get here, right? So this 2s will become, as the value of a is changing from 1 to infinite, right? As the value of a is changing from 1 to infinite, you can just put the values here and you can see what are we going to get. We will be getting a geometric progression here, which is in fact an infinite geometric progression that we'll be getting, right? So let's write this and see what are we going to get, right? When you change the values of a, we will be getting 1 upon 4, that is a equal to 1. And when you take a equal to 2, we'll be getting 1 upon 4 squared. And when a equal to 3, we'll be getting 1 upon 4 cube, and so on. So this will go till infinite. And similarly, when you go back and check, This term is also going to give you exactly the same series. If you put b equal to 1, we'll be getting 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4 square and 1 by 4 cube and so on. So this is also going to give you 1 upon 4, 1 upon 4 square and 1 upon 4 cube, right? So that is what we will be getting in this question. So this can be simply written as whole cube here, right? So because all the three are giving the same series. So now we are going to go for the formula of infinite geometric progression. Sum of infinite geometric progression is given as what? A upon 1 minus R, where A being the first term and R being the common ratio of the GP, that you can directly check from here. The value of A is going to be 1 upon 4 and common ratio is also going to be 1 upon 4, right? You can just divide the second term by first term. You can identify the common ratio is going to be 1 over 4 and the A is also going to be 1 over 4. So now by applying the infinite GP formula for the sum of infinite terms, we will be getting this value inside the bracket as 1 upon 4 upon 1 minus 1 upon 4 whole cube. And now it's very easy to identify what we'll be getting in this bracket. So that will be 1 upon 4 upon 3 upon 4 whole cube, and which is going to give you 1 by 3 whole cube. So which is 1 by 27, right? So here we got the 2s value, which is going to be 1 upon 27, and which is going to give you the value of the sum as 1 upon 54, right? So that is going to be the answer for this question. We just have to make basic modifications in the summation to get the required answer here.